This video shows the preparation of stock 16% paraformaldehyde. I'm going to be making 100 mLs. So the first thing I'm going to do is heat up some water to 60 degrees. Now, I don't know what the volume of the paraformaldehyde powder will be, so I'm measuring 75 mLs. I'm going to pour it into here and warm up that and mix the solution totally and then QS it to 100 mLs when I'm done. Now, if I were making a 1% solution, the volume of the solid would be negligible. But since I'm making a 16% solution, I want to make sure that I don't overfill and make more than my 100 mLs to get 16%. So I'm going to heat it up to 60 degrees. Now, you can turn it up higher to warm it up faster, but I have other things to do, so I'm just going to leave it at 60 degrees. And that should take us only about 15 minutes for it to warm up. While that's warming up, I'm going to measure out my paraformaldehyde. I'm using granular paraformaldehyde. We also have this in a Prill's method where it's a more solid form, but this dissolves quite rapidly. So I'll tear out my weigh boat and measure that out. Now, I don't have the fume hood on for the simple reason that otherwise the air coming into the fume hood might disperse your paraformaldehyde. The granular is not as bad as the older powdered form, but still I don't want to have the fume hood on so the paraformaldehyde doesn't fly all over the place. Since I'm making a 16%, 100 mLs, I want 16 grams. And so I have my 16 grams of paraformaldehyde there, and I want to measure the temperature of my water. So it's right about 60 degrees, and that's pretty good. It can be a little bit warmer, it can be a little bit cooler, but 60 degrees is a good temperature. I'm going to put that on and get my stir bar going. And it's a good idea to start stirring before you start adding the solid. Otherwise, it could form a mass for some materials. I'm going to also turn the temperature up to try to maintain my 60 degrees as much as possible. And I dump that in. Don't have to be too careful, but again, I don't have the fume hood on to avoid any dispersal of my solids. And we can see that goes cloudy. It doesn't go into solution very well, but we're going to take care of that in just a little bit. Don't over spin your stir bar, otherwise you can get a vortex that could splash out. Since this is going now, I'm going to go ahead and turn on the fume hood, because as I heat the paraformaldehyde up and it comes into solution, it is toxic and you don't want to be breathing it. I'm going to let that mix for about 3 to 4 minutes. And in order to clear this so it goes into solution, I have to put in sodium hydroxide. It requires a strong base solution in order to go into solution. So I'm going to put in one pellet of sodium hydroxide first and see how that goes. You don't want to overdo things. And it will start to clear a little bit as the sodium hydroxide goes into solution. It's still cloudy, so I still need to add one more pellet of sodium hydroxide. And I'm going to let that mix. I'm not going to get too carried away, and we can see it starting to clear already. It's only been 6 minutes in terms of the mixing of that. But we can see that the solution is already starting to clear. We still have some pellets moving around in there. So now, after only 9 minutes, the solution is totally clear and is ready to then put into my bottle. And of course, you want to turn off your stir bar and reduce the heat and get things out of the way. When you're working with the liquefied paraformaldehyde, you don't want to have things spill and get equipment out of the way of the fume hood. So I have my paraformaldehyde with a stir bar in there, and of course remember to remove the stir bar before you start to pour so you don't pour the stir bar into your graduated cylinder. What I'm going to do is measure this out. I put in 75 mL to begin with, and then I put in my 16 grams of paraformaldehyde, and we can't know exactly how much volume that 16 grams of paraformaldehyde is going to take up once it dissolves. So as I do that, I see that it's just about 83 mLs. So I'm going to pour a little bit of water in here to rinse out the paraformaldehyde, and I make sure that I don't put in too much. And as I load that up, wouldn't you know it, every once in a while you get a little bit lucky. I poured the exact amount in there, and my beaker is empty. So as I put that into my labeled bottle, 16% paraformaldehyde, and that's a stock solution. So now you can use that to make Karnofsky's fixative or a fixative for labeling that you might use without glutaraldehyde. Straightforward and not too bad. Thank you very much.